And when I got there, I knew they were gone. When I saw all three of them and Veronique.
No way كنت مستنصرة إنه ولادي حيروحوا بهالطريقة أو يلي صار أنا أكبر منها.
إذا بدي انتحر ما حيرجع لي ولادي. شو ما بعمل ما حيرجعوا.
كيف فيك تسامحيه؟ هو قتلنا اخواتنا.
On the 1st of February 2020, on a hot summer day, seven children set off down this road to buy ice cream. Four of them never returned home. Four of them were killed instantly in a horrific car crash. Here, from the scene of the tragedy, we go back to that night, to that horrific night, the night that united a community with tears.
نحن كان عنا 21st birthday وكنت على السريع عم حط ميك اب نزلت بسمع اختي عم بتقول لداني Are you sure انه it's okay تيمشي؟ قال لها داني ايه انه شو حيصير؟ كلها خمس دقايق ورايحين يجيبوا ايس كريم ويجوا. طلعت بالسياره تنجيبهم وانا كنت حاطه ايدي على المسكه عم سكر الباب تنجيبهم بتركض اختي بتقول في شيء صار مع الاولاد بتدفشني بتطلع بالسياره بتقول له مشي داني. بوصل لهونيك وبشوف انجلينا بس انجلينا كانت مبتسمه. فبقى أنا فكرت إنه ما بها شيء إنه عم تبتسم بنتي قدامي بس شفت سيانا مثل انصدمت بعدين شفت أنتوني شربل
فيرونيك
وركضت ليانا عم تبكي قالت لي ماما بدي أخسرك مثل ما بديك مثل ما خسرتهم قلت لها لا ليانا ما حتخسريني ما صار لهم شيء إنه أنجلينا عم تبتسم ودغري بعقلي عم فكر بوزيتيف إنه كلهم حيقوموا كل شيء حيرجع مثل ما كان ما كنت عم فكر انه خلص ولادي ماتوا قدامي ما فقدت الامل.
I looked up in heaven. هلا being a dad, you catch your son if he falls, if he burns his hand, I'll burn my hand with him. يعني there's things you control with your kids, but I knew this wasn't for me to control. This is something where it was a speck on the earth. Something happened there bigger than me and Layla. So I surrendered to God. I said, Lord God, this is something bigger than me. You're in control.
الله لا 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 لا. لكن ما أقف صعب. بيطلع في حد هون وما فيك تبكي. بدك جرب تكوني قوية عند كذبي على حالك. بنتي ولاد بنتك الثانية. ما بعرف بتضيعي ولا فيك تشوفيهم. بتضيعي. بتضيعي يا رب دخيلك اشتغل فيه لاقدر اهدي عائلتي اهدي مرتي اهدي بنتي.
Hi ladies and gentlemen, my name is Sienna Abdullah and I'm gonna be singing a song that I made up. I love my mom and dad. They're my number one favorite and Jesus and God.
My name is Angelina Abdullah and I began attending Tara at the beginning of 2018. I am the second eldest of six children. Which has shaped me into a very responsible young lady.
What do you have to say, Mr. Anthony Abdullah?
Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Mom, so
much. Tell them the story.
I went to shops and I wanted it, and my mom told me that she didn't get it, but then she got it.
على طول أنا وداني عبينا لهم the love tank. على طول فرجناهم قد ايه بنحبهم. وركزنا عليهم نحن ما بدنا العالم تعرفنا انه داني صاحب هالشركه وليلى مرت صاحب الشركه نحن بدنا العالم تعرفنا انه داني وليلى هن اهالي انتوني انجلينا ليانا سيانا اليكس ومايكل وهذا هو فخرنا لانه بالنهايه كله بيزول الشغل والمصاري وبس توصلي انت على on your deathbed بس تاخذي اخر نفس بتقول يا ريت قضيت وقت مع عائلتي مش يا ريت اشتغلت اكثر.
Oatlands tragedy united somehow the community. Everybody wanted to pray. Christians, Muslims, people from all faiths just stood together, sat together, and prayed together.
Christian, they came and prayed with us. Muslims. We got Muslims that came, we prayed together, holding hands with love. Protestant, all walks of life. And we had a letter from a rabbi from the synagogue to reach out. Atheists. And what I think these kids done, it dropped all the walls and showed that we're all human. Humanity came together with all different faiths and it showed a lot of love and respect. Yani, that's something that's special that I find in my heart.
I'd never met him, didn't know who he was, didn't know who his family were. I wanted to say, I just had to hug him. And then when I saw him, I just grabbed him again, like I've known him for years, and I just held him. I stood with them, I just stood by them while they were praying. So religion had really nothing to do with it. I did it from my heart, really, not to prove to anybody that, you know what, I'm Muslim and this is how we should behave and this is how we should act. And I mean, we should all be like that, and it doesn't matter who you are.
الكوميونتي عن جد وقفوا حدنا وما تركونا. بقينا شيء 3 أشهر ما دورنا الغاز ما طبخنا, كل العالم عم تجيب لنا أكل بس والبدي صلي, كل العالم عم تصلي معنا وبعدهم لحد هلا واقفين حدنا ما تركونا. برد على طول ببيتي الأكل, بحبونا, مهتمين بولادنا, وأنا من كل قلبي بشكرهم لأنه عن جد وقفتهم حدي أنا مقدرتها, وإن شاء الله يا رب أقدر أنا أوقف حدهم بوقت أحلى من هيك وقت.
I dropped everything and just did what felt right at the time, and that was to be together. I think we found comfort in each other.
Absolutely.
And we found comfort in praying as a family.
It helps with the grieving when you're standing together and you're praying and you're all in close proximity, and just you can feel the love, and you know, you're sad and you cry, but you're together and you're just working through the motions together.
The cohesion in the community was enormous. Like, it was unbelievable. Just, we drive past the accident site every day. We got no choice, that we have to drive past it every day. And the community, there's always people at the site, people reflecting on the site. It made people closer, you know, made people a bit more aware of what can happen.
Building the house, Anthony, I said to him, Dad, what do you want in the house? Anthony said, Dad, I want a prayer room. I thought, well, I go, why? He goes, Dad, I want to be able to write in my notes, stick it on the wall, whatever prayer I'm requesting, and when God answers my prayers, I can rip it up and throw it in the bin. Anthony had a strong faith. He's always looking at things. I always used to encourage him about effort, you know, and he used to even like, there was a Sylvester Stallone movie where he said, it's not how hard you hit, it's how hard you can get hit and get back up and keep trying. And he used to live off that. He used to say, Dad, I'm never going to give up. I'm going to keep trying every day. And he would try every single day his best.
وحط ايدي على شعره وتاني ايد على منخاره تنيمه, وكانت قل له قدي انا بحبه, قدي فخوره فيه. قل له ماما عطول قول الحقيقه, اتس اوكي اذا انت عملت شي غلط بالحياه, بس عطول قول الحقيقه, ما تكذب. سهيرة كان يكون وقتها انا وانتني, كنت اتلقى حده, كنت اعبته, بوسه, العب له بمنخاره, نيمه. ولما رحت على ال وايت ليدي فيونرال عند شفت ولادي, عملت نفس الشيء كمان, حطيت ايدي على شعر انتوني والتاني على منخاره, غنشته, قلت له شو بحبه, بسته, شميت ريحته, كانت ريحته شامبو. وجربت ارجع اعمل هيدا الشيء اللي بعمله على طول معه لاخر مره بحياتي. هلا to be honest أنا مركزة أكثر علي أنا أليكس ومايكل لأنه الحياة قسيت عليهم والحياة حطتهم بموقف كتير صعب يعني أنتني أنجلينا سيانا حياتهم بحس أهين من اللي أنا أليكس ومايكل وهلا لازم أشتغل أكثر على أولادي يعني إيفن ده أنا نحن هلا حزنانين بس في عندي حلين يا بقعد ببكي بالبيت وببديع وبخسر عائلتي يا لا بوقف على إجري بركز على أولادي أكثر ونحن قررنا لا نركز على أولادنا أكثر لأنه بدنا إياهم يضلوا بإيمانهم ويكفوا بحياتهم ما بدنا شيء يأثر عليهم إذا الحياة قاسية عليهم نحن بدنا نكون واقفين حدهم.
Yeah, at the start, to be honest, the first two or three weeks, I just dared not think about it. It was too much to think about. So, but now it's driving past every day to drive past the site with my children and see them bless themselves every day is very hard. I don't know if my priorities change, but my I'm probably a bit softer on my kids. Maybe I'm a bit easier with them, and I'm a bit more understanding of them. Sometimes I think maybe that's helped me in that way a little bit. I try to be a little bit more understanding with them because some things that we thought were important before clearly are not important now. So it's something that we've had to learn, I guess, along the way.
Everything's changed, and it's changed for the better. And it's also changed the children. You know, they think twice now. My children thought you got old and then you died because they have suffered loss. So they've also learnt life is short.
Around 7:45 p.m., Samuel William Davidson, who was drunk and high on drugs while driving his four-wheel drive, mounted the curb and plowed into the seven children walking on Bettington Road. The tragic accident brought the community to its knees and served as an important reminder about road safety.
Well, you know, when I see the tragedy and I realised that, you know, it was a drunk driver, it made me think about myself. And, you know, we always think we're okay to drive after a couple of drinks. Now I think twice. And, you know, knowing that you're okay or thinking you're okay is not good enough anymore. You know, you could be over the limit and that could be that split second decision that you make that could affect, you know, another family. And I've seen the hurt that it's been with Layla and Danny and Bridget and what it's done to their family, and you just don't want to be responsible for that for someone else.
Oh, hopefully, especially now because my eldest son and his friends, they're starting to drive. So for one thing, it's safety for them when they're driving and what can happen, but also that maybe that there's people like Danny and Layla out there who've lost their children, and that's something that people have to live with. So that might be make my kids more aware of those sorts of things that are happening around them.
لكن بدي أقولك شغلي سبحان الله بيقول طفل الموت يبقى محبوب. هالولاد كانوا غير
بتحضن. عندك 12
حفيد. اسمعي كتر خير بس لا هن بيعرفوا لا بكل ما منا سوري مش لأنه ماتوا عم نحكي هن مميزين من الأساس كل واحد له دور بس هاو مميزين مثلا وقت اللي بيعبطك تحسي حالك رح تفوتي على ألبوم أو إجينا وقت طعبتك بسم الله عجلتها ما بتقولي عمرها 11 سنة وقت طعبتك تفوتك على قلبها هلا هديك الصغيرة عندها نهفات أيطني كان يعذبني مش يعذبني يجي يحاول لأنه في كلمة ما لازم يقولها بلبنان يعني فريش اير باللبناني تفسيرها غير كان معلق علي فيها ونلعب بوكسات تعبي تكوني مع والد مثله تتنبسطي معه كل واحد عنده فاصل بس الأكثر شيء كان
سيانا
بس ما رفعتي من عنا أو هلو 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 ونفتح إيدانا إحنا إنه جاي لعنا تطلع في ستة تقوم ستة تفتح لإيدها هيك أهلا سيانا أهلا سيانا ترجع تطلع فيي تركزي على تطلع فيك أهلا أهلا جدي أهلا جدي أو هاي بروس ده رايحة على الكلب
تاني رايحة على الكلب هي
بحب أحكي عن الله وفرجي كل العالم سورة الله وسورة المسيحية وحتى مش بس سورة المسيحية سورة الإيمان إذا الواحد بيأمن بشي صغير قديش فيك تكوني قوية بالحياة، لأنه بلا الإيمان ما بحس نحنا فينا نعمل شيء.
يعني إيماننا خلينا نعرف ولينا وين نروح وين راحوا. إذا ما معي إيمان ما كان بقدر أعيش على القصة شو صار معنا، كان بيكون كتير صعبة. بس نحن بنعرف أولادنا بالسما.
Layla's faith in all of this has just inspired me to get closer to mine. And so now I go to lessons and I'm trying to better my education about my faith.
After this tragedy, now أنا وابنك تير عم reading Quran together, we praying together. You know, he's very good. هيدك اليوم كان عنده his money from his from Naeed, mm-hmm. and he said, "Dad, أنا بدعتي on هذا لال charity."
The big lesson for me that I took from the tragedy and from Daniel and Layla was how they dealt with the tragedy. They immediately, their instant reaction was to pray for their children, and they invited their friends, they invited their family, their community in to pray with them.
Angelina, she was born 8 weeks early on Christmas Eve. And when we saw her, she was so tiny, she looked like an angel. And that's how we ended up naming her Angelina. And her nickname was my angel, my little helper, my second mom. She was beyond her years. Very hanune, تركض على العالم, قلبها طيب. شفت حالي بأنجلينا كانت تنام المسبحة بإيدها. إذا قال لها بدنا نصلي تصلي مسبحتين بالنهار وبدها تصلي بعد أكثر. كنت حاسة كأنه أنا أمي، يعني كانت
even Angelina
حياتي لك روحي.
At school, the teacher said, we need to talk to you about Angelina. So we went and saw the teacher. And the teacher goes, your daughter has a problem. I go, what's the problem? She goes, she puts others before herself. Our kids were about serving.
نحن بعدنا على مسامحتنا. أنا ما زعلت من الدرايفر، حسيت إنه الله بده أولادي بهيدا الوقت بهالطريقة. وبصراحة أنا بصلي له للسايق، بصلي لكل واحد كان بهيدا الحادث، لأنه هادي عينتنا بتقلنا صلوا وسامحوا، والشي اللي صار أنا ما بدي يخسر، ما بدي أخسر روحي وما بدي أخسر عيلتي، لأنه هيدا الشي بتبين بأولادنا ليانا أليكسو ومايكل. لك شوي شوي عم يتقبلوا الفكرة. بالأول لقوها صعبة إنه كيف فيك تسامحيه، هو قتلنا إخواتنا. بس لأنه شايفيننا أنا وداني مساكين بالفكرة وبعدنا على قرارنا، هلأ بتشوف أولادنا مبسوطين شوية مرتاحين. أكيد ما حيكونوا نفس الشيء، خسروا ثلاثة من إخواتهم، صليب كتير صعب، بس أهين شوي ما إنه هن يكونوا خسروا إيمانهم وجو تعصيب.
Forgiveness is a major part of love. And the reason why I forgave as a father and a husband, because I knew there's a saying in English, it says things are caught, not taught. So well, you can teach your kids something, but if you do something else, they catch that off you. It's contagious. So if I don't forgive and set that example, even if I told them to forgive, they will always not forgive. So I always say you have to lead by example. So I need to lead that house that way, and I don't want no anger, bitterness or revenge in my kids' spirit.
I spoke to Danny about that. About 3 weeks later, حكيت وكانت معه أنا ويا بالسيارة. وقلت له داني هلا الحكي بيني وبينك. قلت له أنت, do you really forgive him? And he said, yes, I do. وقال لي الحديث لا she forgives him. And why he doesn't want to have a bitter house. And how he wants to move on.
Sienna, she had her birthday. It was her 8th birthday, actually. I was away that weekend. Layla said to her, Sienna, it's your birthday. What do you want to do this weekend? We can go to Luna Park, Center Point. She gave her all these beautiful options, and it was a Friday night. She said, Mum, I want to go and feed the homeless and needy. So she went that night. Now, an eight-year-old kid that has a cake, it's for them. She had the cake, and she said to Mum, Mum, there's a girl my age over there. I want to give it to her as a present. Her and her mum. So she walked down and she went up to her and said, this is my birthday cake and this is a present for you to take home at 8 years old.
Okay, you sure? Okay. Mum says okay, thank you.
Diana كانت كل يوم قعد اخواتها حواليها, Alex ومايكل, وتقرأ لهم الإنجيل. And when she finished, تسأل لهم questions to make sure they understood what she read. وإذا ما ردوا عليها تعيط عليهم. Alex, I'm talking. Like, ردة أسمعوني. Alex said to me, he goes, Mom, I miss how Sienna used to read me the Bible. Liana tries to read it for him, but it's not the same. He's just so used to Sienna. وحتى ست أولاد كانوا يعطوا لي نام حدة. لما داني روح يسهر كانت أيام نام هون أنا وأنتني وأنجلينا وليانا وسيانا وأليكس ومايكل. كنا كتير نحب نضل نايمين حد بعدنا نغلب بعدنا. يعني كنا هيك مبسوطين.
We remember the angels every day.
The loss still hurts though. I don't think that hurt will go away.
But I think also now we look at it in a we talk a lot about the memories,
yeah,
the happy times.
We do. And like Sienna is the most vibrant little girl. Even just closing your eyes and listening to her sing or do a cartwheel or do the splits brings so much warmth.
Here comes a wave meant to wash me away, a tide that is taking me
I just hear under. Or the giggling, and that's what I want to remember, because they were happy children. They were the most, they were vibrant, they were their love tanks were full.
Do you like it?
Yeah. If I say more than one, so everyone would have fun. Mom.
My name is Anthony and I'm number one. If you don't believe me, just ask my mom.
Mom!
My little routine, I wait nearly every day. أنا بقوم أربعة. وبرجع من الأوفيس الساعة 5:15 بروح صلي المسبحة ما في شمس it's still dark I go there I pray and I love that moment it's like I've got 20 minutes I'm with my kids I've got my their pictures and we pray and I cry and you know every day I cry I'm not gonna say I don't and I just after I finish my prayers I'm صلي بالبكي بس بقوم وبكمل نهاري بروح على البيت و and I get ready for work and get the kids ready.
وأنا بوعد ولادي تيجي اليوم اللي بدي أشوفهم فيهم أنا حضل ممسكة بإيماني أنا حضل أشتغل أكتر على حالي وعلى إخواتهم وأنا ما حخلي إنه هن تركوا هالعالم حدا ينسيهم أنا عم فكر أكتب كتاب نفتح فاونديشن لألهم وحنضل قد ما فينا نخلي اسمهم عايش للأبد طالما نحن عايشين وعم نتنفس.